Okay, so it's a Friday night, and I wasn't planning on preaching today, but I drove by and I saw this line, and I felt that these people needed a warning, and that their souls are important to God. So I decided to come out anyways, although I wasn't planning. I was planning on doing this tomorrow to do some preaching. So that's what I'm gonna be doing.
The Holy Bible says, do not be deceived. The unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God. Neither fornicators, nor adulterers, nor idolaters, nor the effeminate, nor the homosexuals, nor drunkards, nor thieves will inherit the kingdom of God. I'm here today to warn you that if you live in sin and you die in sin, you'll be judged for your sin and you'll go to hell for your sin. You need to turn from your sin. The Bible says that there is a wide road. Jesus said that there is a wide road that leads to destruction, and many go that way. He also said that there is a narrow way that leads to life, and there are few that go that way. Which way are you on? Are you on the wide road that leads to hell, or are you on the narrow road? The Bible says that behold, the Lord comes with 10,000s of his saints to execute judgment on all and to convict all that are ungodly among them for all of their ungodly deeds which they have committed in ungodly ways, and for all the harsh words that ungodly sinners have spoken against him. So, if you are in sin today, you need to turn from your sin. You need to follow Jesus Christ. He will not lead you into sin. He will not lead you to a nightclub. He will not lead you to be selfish and self-centered. He will lead you to be loving and benevolent. Jesus Christ will lead you to love your neighbor as yourself. So I came out here today because I know that there are a lot of sinners out here in downtown today. And I'm here to warn the sinners that if they continue being sinners, then they will be judged by God. God is going to judge your life. You won't be clapping in hell. God wants you to turn from your sin. Jesus Christ loves you so much that he died to save you from your sin. He didn't die to save you in your sin so you could continue being a sinner, but he died to save you from your sin. So if you're living in sin today, then you need to stop being selfish and self-centered. Sin is always selfish and self-centered. Sin has consequences. If you get drunk, you're destroying your liver. If you get drunk, you might get into a car accident. If you get drunk, you will be judged for God if you die as a drunkard. So if you're a drunkard, if you like to get wasted, then you need to stop it. You need to start living sober. God is also going to judge the fornicators. Those of you that have sex outside of marriage. God says that it is wrong. God did not make you to go and sleep with any person that you meet. He made you to have a spouse. The Bible says that the Lord comes in flaming fire to execute vengeance upon all those that do not know God and do not obey the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. If you're living in sin today, then, and you die in your sin, then you will be judged for your sin. You need to turn from your sin and follow Jesus Christ. The Bible says that hell is not a pleasant place. Jesus says that it is a place where the fire is never quenched and the worm never dies. The Bible says, do not be deceived. The unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God. Neither the fornicators, nor the idolaters, nor the adulterers, nor the homosexuals, nor thieves, nor liars, nor blasphemers will inherit the kingdom of God. If you're on that list, then you need to get off that list. Jesus Christ said,
I don't want to hear your stuff. Can you keep it moving somewhere else? My store, I don't want to hear it. I'll call the cops because of a nuisance. Okay? I don't want to hear it.
This is a public sidewalk.
I don't want to hear it though. You're here in front of a store. You're disrupting my business.
Hop over one spot.
Yeah, bro, I'm not saying don't stop it. Can you just please move over? I don't want to hear it from the store. I don't want to. That's my business. I'm not saying don't preach. Right, you can preach all you want, brother. It's free country.
I'll just move over there.
Yeah, can you move over there? Move anywhere else, please. Not in front of my store. I don't want to hear you. Is that cool?
I'll move this one.
Keep going over there. Thank you. That's all I need.
Thank you.
change. I don't have change. I don't give money usually. Anyways.
Jesus said that if you look upon someone, upon a person, to lust after them, then you've already committed adultery in your heart. The Bible says that adulterers will not inherit the kingdom of God. Jesus said that if your hand causes you to sin, then cut it off and cast it from you, because it is better for you to enter into eternal life without one hand than to be cast into hell with both your hands. So if your hand's causing you to sin, if you're drinking beer or masturbating, then cut it off. Jesus said that if your foot causes you to sin, if you're walking into the nightclub today, then cut it off and cast it from you, because it is better for you to enter into eternal life without one foot than to be cast into hell with both your feet, where the fire is not quenched and the worm never dies. So if you have sin in your life today, God's telling you to do something about it. God wants you to stop it. God wants you to be pure. The Bible says that there is no peace for the wicked. If you are in sin today, then you are at war with God. You need to stop it. You need to surrender. Your sin will not do you any good. Son, so that whoever believes in him might be saved. That the wicked and all nations that forget God will be cast into hell. God is angry with the wicked every day. If you're living in sin, then God is disgusted with you. He's disgusted with the way you're living. You need to turn from your sin and turn to God. There is mercy available for you. if you turn from your sin and turn to Jesus Christ. The Bible says that idolaters will not inherit the kingdom of God. So, if you're not trusting in the only true God of the Bible, in Jesus Christ, then you are on your way to hell. Jesus said that He is the way, the truth, and the life. Buddha was wrong. Muhammad was wrong. Joseph Smith and the Mormons are wrong. So if you're living in sin today, then you're in great danger. If you're living in sin today, you're living in fornication. If you're having sex outside of marriage, then you're in great danger. If you enjoy listening to music that glorifies sin, that glorifies drugs, sex, and violence, then you are in great danger. God wants to save your soul. God's mercy is available as a limited time offer. It will end one day. And you do not know when it will end. It may end tonight for you. God is not obligated to show you mercy.
No, thank you.
Jesus Christ was born to save His people from their sin. Jesus Christ did not come and die on the cross so that you could keep being a sinner. He came to save you from your sin. He came to give you a new heart. The Bible says that sin comes from the heart. Jesus Christ said that not those things that enter into a man defile a man, but those that come out of his heart defile him. He said that fornication comes from your heart. Says that all sin comes from your heart. If you're living in sin and you have a wicked, dirty heart, you need to come to Jesus Christ to get a new heart, to get a pure heart, to have a pure mind. The Bible says that if your name is not written in the book of life, then you'll be cast into the lake of fire. What's that? I don't hear what you're saying. If you're walking into the nightclub to party today, then you're in great danger. The Bible says that those who do not have their names written in the book of life will be cast into the lake of fire. That is the second death. The Bible says that those that the Bible says that if you overcome, then your name will not be blotted out from the book of life. But if you do not overcome, if you are instead defeated by sin, if you give in to sin, if you give in to temptation, and live for yourself, and live for your selfish, self-centered desires, then your name will be blotted out of the book of life, and you will be cast into the lake of fire. But that's not God's will for you. God is not willing that any should perish, but that all would come to the knowledge of God, and that all would have eternal life. God does not desire the death of the wicked, but he would rather that they turn and live. The Bible says that God resisteth the proud, but gives grace to the humble. So if you're disobeying God today, if you're not humble and obedient to God, then God is at war with you. Or you, more precisely, are at war with God. And you're going to lose. God is giving you this time to turn from your sin. The Bible says that the drunkards will not inherit the kingdom of God. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 and 10, do not be deceived. The unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God. Neither the fornicators, as those of you that are sleeping around with your boyfriend or girlfriend, nor the idolaters, as those of you that are not worshiping the God of the Bible in spirit and in truth, those of you that are not following Jesus Christ, that are living in sin, will not inherit the kingdom of God. It also says that adulterers will not inherit the kingdom of God. Jesus said that if you look at someone to lust after them, to desire them sexually, then you have already committed adultery in your heart. God is going to judge your thoughts. He's going to judge your actions and your words. Bible says that you will get an account for every idle word, for every filthy song that you sing, for every filthy thought that you have. God will judge your life. Bible says that God is angry with the wicked every day. So if you're living in sin, and God is angry with you. The Bible says that the law of God is written upon your heart. You have a conscience that tells you that living a selfish life is wrong. That fornication is wrong. That getting drunk and altering your state of consciousness and trying to dull down your conscience is wrong. God wants to save you from your sin.
You guys seem many preachers down here, or no? This common, or no? Someone come out here preach?
Yeah.
I'm being truthful with you. It's not gonna work. You can keep preaching to them, but nobody's gonna listen.
I can't force you.
Yeah, no, yeah. You can keep doing your thing. You're good. God bless you, man. Do your thing.
The Bible says to bless the one, you have to have something to give. So,
that's what it is. Before he's here. Start a ministry.